Welcome to this next lecture on the signals and systems. Now in the last lecture we were solving some problems on the basic operation of the signals. So in this lecture also we will continue to solve the problems based on the basic operation on the signals. Now earlier we solved it for unit step signals and ramp signals. Now we will see the combination of ramp and unit step signals. So the first problem is xt equals to rt minus 1 minus ut minus 1. So in solving this problem we will proceed in a stepwise manner. So this will be the signal rt and this will be the signal rt minus 1 and this will be u of t minus 1. Okay, so the combination of this rt and rt minus 1 we have already had seen in the last lecture that it is nothing but a signal something like this. Okay, so just refer to the last lecture, we had already solved the problem. Okay, so this will be rt minus 1, then the only signal which is being again subtracted from this is the u of t minus 1. Okay, so I am again drawing it u of t minus 1. So now what will be the resultant signal? You can very easily see that after this point 1, this is having of amplitude 1 and this is also having the amplitude 1. So 1 minus 1, that will be 0. So after t equals to 1, this signal will be 0. So from 0 to 1, this will be present. And after t equals to 1, this will be absent. Okay, so this is a straight line from 0 to 1. This is 1. So simple. This is your resultant signal. Okay, fine. Now consider a similar problem. Next we have to plot xt equals to ut plus rt minus twice of rt minus 1 plus rt minus 2 minus u of t minus 1. Okay, so this is a slightly an advanced problem. It consists of many different signals. So what you would have to do is to plot all these intermediate signals and then just obtain the resultant. Okay, so now in starting you can just draw in steps so this will be the signal ut plus rt. Okay, so this is, I'm drawing ut plus rt only. So this will start from 1 and so on. So at this is equal to 2, this will be 1. Okay, so as you might be seeing from here that this constant amplitude is of 1 is being added to the ramp signal, so that will just make this ramp signal starting from 1 and it will go on. Okay, so this is this signal u of ut plus rt, then twice of rt minus 1. It can be plotted as something like this. It is again in a straight line, it will be okay. So this is 1, this is so on 2 and up to t. So this signal will be twice of r t minus 1. Okay, so 1 and 2 and so on. So this signal will be twice of 2RT minus 1. Okay, so if you have to subtract this, like you just solve this signal up to this step, so UT plus RT minus twice of RT minus 1, what you will get? What you will get? You will get a signal something like this. So this point will be 1 and this will be 1, this will be 2, and it will go on. Okay, so this signal is actually ut plus rt minus twice of rt minus 1. So you can very easily see from here that up to this point 1 only first signal is present, so that will come up to 1, and then after this point, because the slope of second signal is greater than the first signal, so that is why the, if you subtract the second one from the first one, the overall resultant will be a decrease in the slope. That is why this decrease here is being shown in the signal. Okay, then next part in the signal is a ramp signal of RT minus 2. So RT minus 2, again you can plot like this. This is 1, this is 2, this is RT minus 2, okay. So this signal will be added in the previous signal which is obtained in the previous step. So this signal plus this signal, it can be added to give something like this. Okay, so 1, 2, and this is 0, this is 1, this is 2. Okay, so because at this time instant t equals to 2, this signal is starting, so the overall effect will be to reduce the slope to 0. Okay, so the slopes will just cancel out each other and the slope will be 0. So whatever be the signal value at this point t equals to 2, that will continue afterwards. And then the last part of this problem is u of t minus 2. This is also to be subtracted. So this is u of t minus 2. This is u of t minus 2. This is to be subtracted from it. So again you can see that after t equals to 2, the amplitude is 1, and the amplitude is 1 here also after t equals to 2. So 1 minus 1, that should be equal to 0. So that means the resultant signal will not be present after t equals to 2. So I am drawing the resultant signal here. So something like this you will get as your answer. This is 1, this is 2, this is 1, this will be 2. Okay. So this is your final answer. This is xt which is being asked in the problem. This will be your resultant answer. So you might have got some idea that just by drawing the intermediate signals and then adding or subtracting them together, you can obtain the resultant signal. Okay. One more problem. Now the next problem states that you have to draw d by dt of rt minus 1 minus u of t minus 1. Okay. This you have to plot. So if you recall what I have told you earlier, that the derivative of the ramp signal will come out to be an step signal, whereas the derivative of a unit step signal will be an impulse signal, unit impulse signal. Okay. So if you just combine these two informations in the solution, what you will get is the derivative of the ramp will be this ut minus ut minus 1, and the derivative of the unit step will be del t minus 1. Okay. So if you have to plot this, now up to this point you have gained very good understanding of how to draw these signals. So I can draw it directly also, but let me just draw in steps here. This is ut and this is second one is ut minus 1. So you will get a signal like this. This is u of t minus u of t minus 1. And then you are seeing one more thing is here, that an impulse signal is located at t equals to 1. Okay, so obviously this is shifting in the impulse signal, and it is located at t equals to 1. So this is already t equals to 1, but you are also seeing one more thing here, that the amplitude of this impulse signal is negative. That means it will be drawn below the axis. So it will just be drawn in the continuation of this. It will be in a straight line. Okay, so you can draw it. Let me just draw this straight line. So something like this you will get an impulse signal in the downward direction at t equals to 1. Okay, so this will be your resultant signal, and obviously the amplitude of this impulse signal will be 1 minus 1 in the negative direction. The amplitude will also be 1 because all these signals are unit step signals, unit signals, okay, unit amplitude signals. Next, you have got one more problem. Xt equals to 2 plus 1 minus ut plus rt minus 1. Okay, so if you see at the starting of this problem that this waveform we have already drawn in earlier problems. Okay, I think just the first problem which we have solved in this lecture, there we had drawn this waveform rt minus 1. So you can just refer to that. Okay, I think rt minus 1, you go back to the first question which I had solved today. The waveform will be something like this. This is rt minus rt minus 1. Okay, all these steps are explained there, you can see from there. So this is rt minus rt minus 1. The only extra part which is added here is this u of t plus 1 minus ut. Okay, so what will be u of t plus 1? U of t plus 1 will be from minus 1 to this up to t, and this will be minus u of t plus 1, and what will be ut? Ut you already know that this will be ut. Okay, so u of t plus 1 minus ut, what you will get? You will get a signal this. Okay, so this will be u of t plus 1 minus u of t. So the amplitude is 1 from minus 1 to 0. And for all these subsequent values, since this is subtracting, so 1 minus 1 will be 0. So it will be 0 for all the values greater than 0. Now what you have to do, you have to add these two signals. Okay, these two signals will be added in this problem. You have to add them together. Just add them. Okay, so very easy to add them together. Both these are actually for different time durations. So you can see that from minus 1 to 0, this part of unit step is present. So this will be present because from minus 1 to 0, there is no signal here. This is 0. So whatever be this step part, this will come here from minus 1 to 0. And from values greater than 0, this part is present and the step part is absent. So whatever be the signal here from greater than 0, you can just draw it in this manner. So this will be your resultant signal. So this is what has been asked in the question. Ut minus 1 minus ut plus rt minus 1. Okay, so in this way this will be solved. Now coming on to the next problem, xt equals to d by dt of minus ut plus 1 plus rt plus 1 minus rt minus 1 minus ut minus 1. So now I would write it directly as minus del t plus 1 plus ut plus 1 minus ut minus 1 minus del t minus 1. Okay, so the derivative of this part is written here. The derivative of this part is this. Derivative of ramp is again unit step, and the derivative of unit step is an impulse signal. So for drawing this waveform, you can first draw this part ut plus 1 minus ut minus 1. So I will draw it directly because by now you have gained a lot of idea that how these type of waveforms will be plotted. So this will be from minus 1 to 1. Okay, and what is this? This is u of t plus 1 minus u of t minus 1. Okay, so now these two impulses have to be added in this signal. Now there is an impulse located at t equals to minus 1, which you are seeing here, and there is an impulse located at t equals to plus 1, and the amplitudes of both these impulse signals are negative. So both these impulse signals at t equals to minus 1 and at t equals to plus 1, that will be drawn in the downward direction. Okay, so if I should draw it in the downward direction, that will be in the downward direction. So it will be this and it will be this. Okay, so again these will be straight lines and the amplitude will be same, is minus 1. Okay, so this is how the problems related to the basic operations of the signal, and we have now come to the end of the problems which are related to the basic operations. We have seen a lot of different types of problems which consist of the unit step signal, the ramp signal, the impulse signal, the combination of these two signals, and also the derivative, the problems consisting of the derivatives of one particular signal. In this I have told you that the derivative of unit step will give you the impulse signal, the derivative of ramp will give you the unit step signal, and if you proceed in the opposite direction, that means if you integrate an impulse signal, you will get a unit step signal, and if you will integrate a unit step signal, you will get a ramp signal. So this is the order of obtaining the different signals. So this is how these type of problems are solved. I have gave you a lot of idea, and one more thing I would like to tell, that the step wise manner, actually it can be different. It is not necessary that you only proceed in this way, or you can also solve the same problem just by drawing the different signals and just adding or subtracting them in different ways. Okay, so I suggest that you try these problems and try to solve these type of problem on your own, and you also see some more problems given in the book and try to solve these also. Okay, so with this much we have come to the end of this lecture, and in the next lecture we'll try to solve the problems related to the properties of the impulse signals which we have discussed, like the shifting property, scaling property of the impulse signal which we have discussed in the starting of the lectures. Okay, so with this much we stop for today, and we will meet in the next lecture. Okay, thank you very much.